Hi Libra, welcome to January in 2019. Happy New Year. This is Teresa from Tarot by T. And before I start your reading, I want to call in some good energy and create some sacred space around this reading. And I want to say thank you for liking and subscribing to my channel. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for those who have taken time out to leave comments. I really enjoy reading the feedback. And for those who've ordered readings, thank you for your support. I've enjoyed working with all of you. And if you're new watching this channel, welcome. And Happy New Year. So, what's coming up for Libra? We have a new moon solar eclipse in Capricorn on January 5th. And we have a full moon lunar eclipse in Leo at 0 degrees. On January 20th and possibly the 21st, depending on where you live. So what does Libra need to know about love, career, life, anything important? What is coming up for Libra in January? What does Libra need to know for January? What are the important energies coming up for Libra in January? Okay, the Four of Wands, the Ten of Pentacles, wow, the Four of Pentacles, the Wheel of Fortune, the Seven of Wands, the Ten of Wands, the Eight of Wands, the Empress, the Queen of Wands, the Ten of Swords. Okay, so the Four of Wands. Okay, you have a couple of tens. You have three tens. So you're definitely ending a cycle. Something is coming to completion. But the Four of Wands, you're starting the month off with victory and financial success. Victory, stability, this could be a card of marriage. This is a card of security, home, money, being surrounded by abundance, surrounded by family, the people you love. If you've been worried about money, holding on to money, financial security, you're going to be achieving that in January. It seems like your luck is changing. The Wheel of Fortune is opportunity. You know, nothing lasts forever. So I feel like if you've been through a difficult time, that is over. The Ten of Swords means something has ended. You may have felt that a part of your life, you were just beaten down by life. But you're going to rise again. You're rising in January. Opportunities, new opportunities are coming. The Wheel of Fortune is a change. Nothing lasts forever. Things are changing. You have the Seven of Wands and the Ten of Wands in the future. The Seven of Wands is standing your ground, fighting the opposition. So if you have any obstacles that are in your way, you have the upper hand. So if you're doing something, let's say, there's a lot of wands in this reading, so I'm almost thinking it's career-based more than love, although it could be relationship as well, because I'm seeing family. And but as far as a career situation goes, if you feel that there's a lot of competition, you have the upper hand. You don't have to worry. I mean, you could hold your ground among all the other competitors, let's put it that way. You might be standing up for something you believe in, setting boundaries. You might be fighting for something that you believe in, standing up. I feel like you're standing up against opposition, that maybe there are people around you that don't agree with your methods or don't agree with your opinions, but you're standing your ground. And just that dedication and just that determination is going to lead you to success. You've been carrying a heavy burden, but you're going to be putting that down as well, because this is ending. Your burdens are ending. Maybe you've been working a lot, working two jobs or just carrying a lot of responsibility. That's coming to an end. This is a card of just, you know, putting down your load, you know, dropping your bags. And so that, and then Eight of Wands here. The Eight of Wands is opportunities, new beginnings, things happening quickly, travel, journey by air. So there could be some new career or work opportunities coming up. So if you're in a business, if you're working for yourself or you're working for someone else, there's going to be opportunities to advance. If this is in your negative thinking sector, so you might be doubting that this is even possible. Well, you need to stop that. Don't doubt that you can have opportunity. I think it's because you've been through so much in the past that you just feel beaten. You have no energy. It's just like, oh, I don't know if I could fight anymore. I don't know if I could move even. I feel like I'm down for the count. But that things are changing. Abundance. This is the Empress in your environment. This is a card of creativity, motherhood, abundance, birth. So for some of you, if you're in a relationship and you're wanting to have a family, this can mean marriage and children, or that family is really important. Family is going to help you get through whatever hardships you've been through, whatever like you have suffered. It's over. This is a card of it's over. Something has come to an end. It's no longer affecting you. And so you have to like release it. And the sun is rising on the horizon. So it's like a new day is dawning. The Queen of Wands. This is your wish fulfillment sector. So you're going to have to... This is a card of taking a leadership role in your life. You're going to start to take charge of your life. You realize that a cycle has ended. And you're not carrying the same burden that you were carrying all these years or months. Your burdens are lessening and you're surrounded by people who love you, family, children, abundance. Sometimes the Queen of Wands could represent a fire sign. So maybe you were dealing with a fire sign in the past. But whatever it is, the Queen of Wands also represents the energy of someone who knows what they want and goes after it. So if you've been feeling tired and you haven't really gone after what you want, January is the month that you might get re-energized and you might decide, I know what I want now and I'm going to go for it. And I'm going to put behind any kind of, failure is not an option. Yes, I might have failed in some cases I might have experienced loss and I might have experienced betrayals and I might have experienced, you know, being beaten down by life. But I know that those things don't last forever and I can get up, I can rise again like the phoenix. You're going to rise out of the ashes and you're going to create a new life for yourself and maybe even new relationships. Because I see you surrounded by love. I see you surrounded by, like, family. You have a lot of people around you. You have support. So whatever you've been through, you're coming out of a bad time. You're coming out of a dark time. And you're moving into a much more prosperous time and a happier time and a more secure time. So let's see what the astrology has to say for Libra. So you have a new moon, solar eclipse, in the fourth house. You have Sun, Moon, Pluto, Saturn, even Mercury is in Capricorn in the fourth house. So you have a chance to have a new beginning within your home and within your family. The fourth house is the house of home. It's, you know, your roots. Maybe you're reconnecting with family. Maybe there have been some major changes because Pluto's been in your fourth house. Pluto can sometimes disrupt the home with transformative events and energy. But Saturn in the fourth house helps you put down roots. You're realizing the value of family. You're realizing the value of having a home and having a stable home. And that's become more important to you. Whatever you were dealing with in the past, you're realizing how important family is and how important it is to have a home base, to feel at home within yourself, and to have a home that you can come home to and recharge. You might even be dealing with issues from childhood, that maybe some psychological things that you have to deal with that are coming up. You know, Pluto might be bringing things up from the past that you have to face and release. But when you come out of it, you'll be stronger. You have Neptune in the sixth house, and it's sextiling all of this energy. So maybe you're starting a business in the home, a dream. But Neptune's the house of the planet of creativity, spirituality. You might be starting a new business that involves some type of creative project. Healing, even. Neptune is the healer. You know, it has to do with medicine and healing and hospitals. Having compassion, caring about people less fortunate than yourself. So you might be involved in some type of work that helps others in some way, in some health, like a service, providing service for others. You have Venus in the second. That's bringing in money, honey. So, and Uranus and Mars are in your seventh house. That can bring unexpected changes in relationships and partnerships, both business and personal. Uranus can bring an exciting romance or exciting partnership that makes you feel more alive. And with Mars there, it could be there could be some physical attraction too. You might even butt heads on occasion, but it's an exciting partnership. It's not one of these dull, you know, routine, yes, dear kind of things. It's more of a, you know, this person is very independent and needs a lot of freedom. So, but it brings excitement to your life. It could also be a partnership that involves, if it's business, it could involve technology or breaking new ground, you know, going off the beaten path. Full moon lunar eclipse is happening in your 11th house and your 5th house. So yeah, there could be some, it's either love, romance, because the 5th house is, it could be like the culmination of a romance. Like if you meet someone in January, you may decide to start dating, but it could also be creativity, that you're finishing up some creative project that's very important to you, that's bringing a dream to fulfillment, because the 11th house is the house of friendship, group, so you might even be forming a relationship with a friend. Or you're joining a group that's going to help you fulfill a dream or a goal. You're going to be a very charming communicator in January at this full moon. So if you're writing, if this is a good time for you to write, if you're involved in any kind of marketing plan or any kind of a creative writing project, you're going to be very charming because you have Venus in your third house. You're going to be charming the pants off people in January. So I think this is good for creativity. I think that January is going to be a very creative month. And so if it's not a new love, or if it's not, you know, bringing children into the world, you might, or, you know, celebrating with your children, you know, enjoying family and home, you could be actually doing something that's very creative and very fulfilling. You could be expressing yourself in a creative way, either through writing or through music or through art or through any kind of self-expression. That's going to be very fulfilling for you, and it could even bring in some extra income. So the worst is over. It can only get better. Things are going to only get better. So put down your burdens. Your burdens are ending. Embrace the new opportunities. Don't be afraid to embrace new opportunities. And don't be afraid to let yourself, to express yourself. Don't be afraid to try new things. Don't, you know, Get up off the floor, dust yourself off. A new day is dawning. That's what I have to say. So, Libra, I hope that you have enjoyed this reading. And I wish you much success, much love, much abundance in January and throughout the year. If you'd like a private reading, you can click on the link in the description box. But January looks great. So, I hope you enjoyed this reading. I will talk to you again next month. Okay, bye now.